Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to the monthly for January 2016, where we will look back very briefly on what happened in December 2015 and then look forward as to what we will be expecting in January of 2016. As foreshadowed, December 2015 was filmed with Fallout 4 guides. Those guides will be being continued until every single item of import has been covered. However, moving on into 2016, we will be seeing more Elder Scrolls coming back. However, for January, I am going on holiday twice, so I will be away for more than half of January, so of course that will lead to much less content during this January. But do not be disheartened, as there is plenty of awesome stuff coming up. Before we get to the Q&A for this monthly, there was of course an overwhelming amount of requests and questions as to whether Skyrim's CCC series will be continuing, when the Oblivion's Easter eggs video will be created, also when more Elder Scrolls 6 discussion videos will be made, and a request for curating curious curiosities in Fallout 4. Now of course there has been a massive lack of Elder Scrolls stuff because Fallout 4 came out, and then leading up to Fallout 4 I was trying to get all the Fallout 3 and Fallout New Vegas videos done, so a couple months before and the couple months after Fallout 4's release was very, very Fallout heavy and very much lacking in Elder Scrolls stuff. And that's why we're looking at Elder Scrolls Online in the background now, just so we can look at a waterfall instead of the barren wastelands of Fallout. As mentioned before, the Fallout 4 guides and videos will be continuing into 2016 until every video that needs to be done is done. However, that upload schedule will be peppered with more Elder Scrolls videos. Of course, the Elder Scrolls 6 discussion series will be continuing in full force, probably not till February, just because I'm working on a big video at the moment, and of course it's now January and I'm going on holidays twice in January, so I can only do so much in 2 weeks. However, the video I am working on at the moment, I think you will enjoy. It will be the first ever curating curious curiosities for Fallout 4. And before the CCC Skyrim clan gets disheartened, there's two very good and sensical reasons as to why I'm making a Fallout 4 CCC before the next Skyrim CCC. But I will explain that a little bit later on in the video. But for now, as you can see, I have gone to the Fallout 4 map and split it into 10, kind of, although the sizes of the sections may not be similar, the amount of curious content within each of those sections is about the same. So I've gone and split the map into 10 equally curious portion sections, so as far as vanilla Fallout 4 goes, there will be 10 curating curious curiosities videos for Fallout 4. And at the moment I'm working on the Northwestern video, which is the area you can see highlighted on the map here. And here's a quick glimpse at the thumbnails that I have made for Fallout 4's curating curious curiosities series, so get excited for that. Also, of course, Fallout 4's fantastic face-off is ending in less than a week, I do believe. For those that don't know and that do have Fallout 4, I have created a competition where all you need to do is get a photo of someone, yourself, a celebrity, and then make your Fallout 4 character's face as similar as you can to that picture of the person you have chosen. All you need to do is do that, make a Twitter account, and post it with the hashtag FO4FFO, standing for Fallout 4's Fantastic Face-Off. I'll put a link in the description and in the comments for that video that explains everything about it, so you can check it out if you'd like. And of course there are excellent prizes that actually arrived today in the mail from Bethesda's store in the US. The box had the absolute shit battered out of it, but everything inside was in perfect condition. So now we'll move on to the Q&A for this monthly, and the last question of the Q&A will lead into the Skyrim CCC videos and the Oblivion's Easter eggs videos and what's going on with them. So the first question you'll see is, would you do a Fallout 4's first reaction video for the first 30 minutes to hour of gameplay? The answer to that is no. I've done one reaction video once and it was horrendous. So no more reaction videos. Angelica, I wonder, is there a video game character you think you'd do a better job voicing, or maybe there is a character that doesn't have a voice and you would like to do that? Just out of all the characters from all the games, who would you voice given the choice? Oof, tough question, Angelica. Maybe Creeper from Morrowind? If you don't know who that is, you can look him up, he's a scamp. But if there's any games that need a talking camel, I mean, how am I not the man for the job? Because that's such a good question that I can't answer that well. Why don't you all let me know who you think I could voice in a video game? Toby, Camel, have you watched Cool Cat Saves the Kids? If you're talking about that video where the kid's on that plastic tricycle and the dog comes around the corner and grabs his leg and then the cat flies out of nowhere and the boys hits the dog in the head, I have seen that. The Smools, what would you most like to see modded in Fallout 4? I would like to see insanely better textures. That would be great. Because most of my videos are very visual, I put a lot of time and effort into trying to make them as cinematic as I can. So better textures would just make that a more pleasant experience for us all. Another big one would be some kind of combat mod that fixes the awful finishing moves and things in Fallout 4. Especially some of the melee ones, some of the sword gets stabbed through. It has no weight at all. It's literally like the clipping on the enemy's body is turned off and the sword's just moving around when it's meant to be stabbed. I don't know, it looks silly. So I would like to see a mod that fixes combat and makes it look legit. Who do you love more, your family or God Howard? I'm actually a clone of Todd Howard, so same thing. Henry, favorite character in all of Elder Scrolls and Fallout? For Fallout, I reckon Nick Valentine. That dude's cool. And I also noticed that Nick Valentine has the exact same voice as Mercer Frey from Skyrim. And I looked it up, and it's the same voice actor. Oh, for Elder Scrolls, Jesus. I'm gonna have to have two here. The first one would be Lucian Lechance from Oblivion, the leader of the Dark Brotherhood. Even just down to the way he sounded, like the sepulchral speech and so on, he really was the Dark Brotherhood in a human. And secondly, which is actually my first favorite character from the Elder Scrolls series, is Yagram Bagan, master crafter in the service of the chief tonal architect Lorg Kagrenak, and the last known living Dwemer. During the Battle of Red Mountain, when all other Dwemer disappeared, Yagram Bagan was in an outer realm, which I assume is another term for a plane of oblivion. When he returned, his people were gone, and just like everyone else on Tamriel, he has no idea what happened to his people, and as far as we know, still remained in Morrowind 200 years before the events of Skyrim as the last living Dwemer. And for everyone watching, also, let us know who your favorite character is in the Elder Scrolls and Fallout. I'm sure I've missed like 100 awesome characters. Riku asks, what do you do on your free time, Camel? In my actual free time, I usually work all the time unless I'm going out to do something specifically. Normally when I'm at home, if I'm not working, I'll be writing music, which doesn't happen too frequently, but yeah, YouTube's a weird job where it's not like you work a shift. Like, all the time you're at home, you're constantly working on something to do with YouTube. So if I'm not doing something obvious like filming or playing a game, I will be doing something like editing JPEGs or researching for a video. And while I do that, I listen to music and podcasts and stuff like that. So yeah, that's pretty much what I do in my spare at-home time. But then, of course, I go out of my way to go and see my friends. How old are you? I am 23 and will be 24 on the 3rd of February. So if more than 365 people viewed this video, there should be at least someone who has the same birthday as me. How do we ask you a question? Well, with grammar aside, you just did. What got you into music? Well, I assume you mean writing music, and I don't know. I thought it was something really cool that I wanted to do. Although I have no musical training or background, I was like, screw it, I'm gonna give it a crack, and I did. So if you do have a dream and you want to do it, do it. That's the best way to do it, is to actually do it. Anthony asks, Fallout 4 will be out by the next Q&A, so I'll ask this in advance. How are you liking the game? Overall, Fallout 4 didn't live up to its hype. Just because I love the series doesn't mean I'm gonna fanboy and be like, it's the best game ever. It's not. That's why they didn't win Game of the Year. That's why they didn't win any of the Game of the Year awards. The wait for it to come out was too long for what we got, if that makes sense. I would give it between a 6 and a 6.5 out of 10. 7's too cliche. 7 is the most cliche, like, yeah, it's good, but it's not bad, so I'm gonna give it a 7. Yeah. 7's such an everyone wins number. No. It's a 6 or a 6.5. And I don't mean to put a big downer on everyone's Fallout 4 experience and all that, but I mean, it's honest. If we want Bethesda to win Game of the Year and deserve a Game of the Year award because their game is the best game, we need to tell them honestly so they can make changes. Matthias, did you know that CamelWorks' profile picture is actually not a camel, but a dromedary? Just wanted to share that. So a bit of a strange statement, and it's incorrect yet correct at the same time. That's like saying your picture isn't a dog, it's actually a Labrador. Camel is actually a name given to any even-toed ungulate in the genus Camelus. So a dromedary is the species, whereas the genus is Camelus. And of course the two surviving species of camels are the dromedary, or the one-humped camel, Camelus dromedarius, and the Bactrian, or the two-humped camel, Camelus bractrianus. So although he's correct in that it's a dromedary is a type of camel. So the camel is the dog part and the dromedary is the Labrador part. Next, Darkeye says, what's the program he used called? And this came off last month's monthly where the whole video is me in Photoshop, so that answers your question. It was Photoshop I was using to edit those thumbnails. Yes, the stash was shaved. Ha 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 ha, don't worry, it's grown back. No, you shaved the stash. Once again, don't worry, the stash has grown back. Movember's over, so the mo is on the grow. Ugh, this is the worst rhyme ever. Kiefer Funk, why do all the tattoos in Fallout 4 look like they were put there after a beer too many? That's true, tattoos in Fallout 4 stink. They look rubbish. Yeah, I feel like Bethesda really missed a trick here. I mean, they could have had some awesome, like, you know, body tattoos, neck tattoos, whatever. There's one on the neck which looks like a cartoon, as do all the others, but the rest are like random symbols on the forehead and stuff. Like, you missed a trick, Bethesda. Penultimately, and Angelica's back. And although it's quite long, it is a good question. Okay, so the Elder Scrolls games are obviously RPGs, but there isn't that much of a role your character has. Sure, you can customize his or her appearance and choose dialogue options, but there isn't any character development. You can be of any unique class and grow as that class, mechanically, but as a person, you don't grow at all. You can be a vampire, you can kill your own wife / husband, and still have a bunch of people asking you for help that you agree to with polite lines and stuff. Isn't that weird? As if I wasn't a full character, but just a tool to play in the game. Like the protagonist isn't fully into the game himself. So do you think that this kind of protagonist is better for an open world game like the Elder Scrolls games, or do those games lose a lot by not making the protagonist richer? That's a very good question, Angelica, and I suppose at the end of the day it comes down to opinion. I think for a game like Witcher 3, having a voiced protagonist worked. Because you were given one character to play, a specific character, Geralt, with a specific look, a specific personality, a specific voice, so all of those things work together to make that character and make it way easier for the development team to make a world that can react to that character. But for games like Fallout 4 and future Elder Scrolls games, where they say you can play as whoever you want, you can make any character you can think of, that's who you can play. They really cannot emulate the range of voices and personalities and responses needed to reflect, you know, an infinite amount of character choices. So instead of trying to do it a little bit, just don't do it at all, I think. In future games, leave the player's character without a voice. Don't cut to their face during a conversation either. In fact, the less your character says overall, I think makes it better, because then it leaves so much room for your imagination to fill in. Like in Morrowind, not even the NPCs had a voice. It was all text-based. You could read it at your own speed. You didn't have to spam A as you went through 30 different dialogue screens that came up as the NPC told you about a quest where you could just follow the quest marker anyway. So yeah, I think Bethesda needs to stop trying to make the characters say what the player is thinking. Leave the character's dialogue as small as you can and let the player fill in all of that good stuff in their heads, because then that way their imagination fits perfectly with their character, instead of fitting, say, one voice to everyone's choice of character. And voice does matter. That's why they choose specific voice actors to do specific characters. So yeah, for games like Witcher 3, it works perfectly because it's built, the whole world's designed around one specific guy. But for a game where freedom is basically the icing on the cake and what makes the game what it is, it really doesn't work, in my opinion, for Fallout 4 and future Elder Scrolls games. And the final question for the Q&A, which is going to segue into the Skyrim CCC and the Oblivion's Easter egg video and where they are. And in advance, I apologize to anyone that is not into computer specs. Question is, what is your entire PC setup, specs, monitor, etc.? So I'll leave all of these stats in the description as well. So first of all, at the moment, I'm using a Gigabyte Z97X SoC Force motherboard. Slammed into that, I have the Intel i7-4790K 4.4 GHz CPU. Also, I have two 8GB sticks of Kingston HyperX Predator 2133MHz RAM. The graphics card is currently a Gigabyte GeForce GTX 98 G1 Gaming 4GB graphics card. Still in its stock closed loop, I have the Corsair H100 water cooling loop that cools the CPU. For the power supply, I have the Corsair CS850M. In terms of hard drives, I've got three Hitachi HGST 3.5-inch NAS 3TB hard disk drives. Again, I've got three of those, so 9TB all up. And one Kingston HyperX 240GB SSD solid-state drive. And that is all slammed into the Thermaltake Core V71 case. The full tower, of course. The only two fans that I didn't replace replaced with two front 200mm thermal take fans that come with the case. But for the rest of the fans, I replaced them with a Corsair Air Series AF140 Quiet Edition. AF meaning airflow and 140 meaning the size, of course. Then I slapped some LEDs into it and it looked something like that computer on the right. That computer on the left is the old computer, which the monitor I'm currently using came with. We'll get to that in a second, but as you can see in the picture, power supply I used to have was the Evo Blue 2.0, which is the one that blew up and destroyed all of my hard drives, thank you very much. And the graphics card in the case in the picture is a 780, which of course was replaced by the 980. So the monitors, I have two HP 2159M 21.5 inch monitors. They are old, I swear that I've had them for at least 5 years, but I've never had any problems with them, so I've never needed to replace them. However, I do want to get two 4K monitors. The only problem I see is that the ratios are different. 1080p is 16 to 9 or 9 to 16, whereas 4K is 16 to 10 or 10 to 16. So if I filmed it, it would be in a different size. So on YouTube, there'll be black bars on it. I don't know, if someone could explain to me how to get 4K monitors and still record and have it work and fit perfectly on YouTube, that would be great. And I use Windows 7 Professional Edition. Windows 8 and Windows 10, I've heard nothing good about them, to be honest, and I've never had any issues with Windows 7, although the issues I have had are things like old games not working, which of course are much, much, much worse on Windows 8 and Windows 10. There's a video of Mr. Matty Plays trying to play Oblivion on Windows 10, and it looked like a nightmare. And finally, I use the Blue Yeti microphone. I use the Razer Black Widow Ultimate Edition. I think this is a 2013 version, and for the mouse I used the Razer Imperator. Now that's all well and dandy, but I'm actually upgrading just about every single part of that computer. I built that would have been about a year and a half ago now, the one that I'm using currently, so I'm fully upgrading everything. And I will run through all the stuff that I have gotten. I've pretty much decided and bought everything. I'm just waiting for delivery at the moment. But the fact that I'm going to be upgrading the computer is why I haven't done the Oblivion Easter Eggs video, and I haven't made any more Skyrim CCC videos recently. First of all, Oblivion has been playing up. When I play it, when I move around, it's like super jagged and jittery. And that only happens when I film, by the way. When I'm just playing, it's fine, but as soon as I click record, it dies. And there's no mods, there's no, like, nothing's being pushed to a limit. So because that's gonna take so much tweaking and endless forum diving to figure out what's wrong with it and to fix it, I don't want to fix it and then have to build a new computer and then have to refix the same problem, or perhaps even encounter new problems. And same goes for Skyrim. Before I do another CCC, I'm going to put a link on screen and in the description and in the comments, and I really want you guys to check it out, because that's how I'm going to be modding out Skyrim to look for the next CCC video and the future Skyrim videos. I have said in the past that I don't like to mod Skyrim out too much, because then it doesn't feel like Skyrim, it feels like something else, but this shit looks better than Witcher 3, and to me, it still feels Skyrim. Whenever I look at any point of this video where the guys have modded it out, I still go, that is Skyrim. I know exactly where they are. Everything just looks almost real. So yeah, for the next Skyrim video, I will be attempting to make my game look the same as theirs does. There's a couple of mods that I won't be putting in. Honestly, I don't know that much about computers. I know what I have to. I just force myself to learn stuff so I can do what I need to do. But modding, putting lots of mods into Skyrim, probably take me more than a day, especially configuring them and making them work together. And I don't want to do that and then build a new computer and have to redo it. So I'm just waiting until I get the new computer fully built before I mess around with Skyrim or Oblivion. But seriously, check out that video where they mod Skyrim out. Also, for those of you that like Skyrim CCC series, you should get pumped, because there are 3 bonus videos for Skyrim's CCC series. I have spent literally about 3 days making 3 thumbnails. As you know, with the other holds, they already come with these banners, the sigils that represent that hold. But for the 3 bonus areas, I had to create their own sigils, which took a lot of time to do. Here's the one for Blackreach, which is some kind of Dwemer cog, and it has the Ethereum shard, the symbol on the Ethereum shard, and I've incorporated that into a cog. For the Forgotten Veil, I have attempted to replicate the symbol that is on top of all of Uriel's shrines, or Auriel's shrines, Ariel's shrines, whatever god slash demigod that is. And for the Soulcan, I have taken a bird's eye view shot of the staircase that leads to the Soulcan from the castle, then taken the silhouette of that and put it into some ritualistic circle.
well.
So there will be those three bonus videos for Skyrim CCC series. I've also gone and redesigned the Solstheim sigil or banner because I wasn't too happy with the original one, which is now deleted so I can't show you, but if you look at the end of the CCC videos that are already up, you'll see the original Solstheim symbol that I created, and you'll be able to see that this one is so much better. So yeah, instead of 10 Skyrim CCC videos, we're going to now have 13. Oh, so what's this computer we all have to wait for, right? Alright, someone's gonna be fapping to this list of components. The motherboard is the Gigabyte GAZ170X Gaming G1 motherboard. Getting slapped straight into the middle of that motherboard is the Intel Core i7-6700K CPU. The RAM is going to be 4 8-gigabyte sticks of the Corsair Dominator Platinum DDR4 3000MHz RAM. Although it only recently happened, the graphics card is going to be upgraded once again to the EVGA GeForce GTX Titan X superclocked 12GB graphics card. I will still be using the 3 3TB Hitachi hard disks and the Kingston HyperX 240GB solid-state drive. However, I will be welcoming the Kingston HyperX Predator PCI Express 480GB SSD and the Samsung 850 Evo Series 2TB 2.5-inch solid-state drive. All the fans in the case have been replaced with Corsair Series SP140 blue LED fans, and if it's not an SP140, it'll be an AF140. I think in total there's 4 AF140s and 2 SP140s. And to control all the fans, we will have the NZXT Sentry 3 fan controller. And to power it all, I have the Corsair HX1000i 80+ Platinum 1000 watt power supply. Now to cool all of that down, I will be building a custom water cooling loop. Luckily, the Gigabyte GAZ170X Gaming G1 motherboard comes with a water cooling system ready to be plugged into the loop. The basis of my custom loop is going to be the SwiftTech 240X, housing both the radiator and the pump. Of course, that will go straight to the motherboard, then it will go from motherboard to CPU. Then from CPU, we will go to the graphics card, where I have bought a SwiftTech Komodo NV GTX Titan X Luxury Edition water block for the GPU, so the fan on the graphics card will come off and I'll slap this metal thing on it, and the temperatures of the graphics card will literally halve. We will also have the 250mm T-Virus reservoir with ice blue coils and a UV cathode, and also the 2-bay front reservoir, which will have the same thing. In this picture it's red, but as you can see, you know, where the CD drives and other bay related pieces go, taking up two of the bays is this T-Virus reservoir, which will have the same ice blue color coils, and then of course with the UV cathode in the middle. And because the size of this loop will be pushing the pump in the SwiftTech 240X to its limits, at the bottom of the loop, which is about in the middle, I will be slapping in an extra pump, which will be the AlphaCool VPP655 variable speed pump HF top edition, which as we can see is acrylic, so it will catch all of the light nicely. But it's a D5 pump, so it's pretty powerful, so it will be able to push all that water up through the reservoirs, no problem. Joining it all together, I will be using a large variety of silver Bits Power compression fittings, joined together with a MasterClear tubing PVC UV reactive clear blue, 1/2 inch inner diameter and 3/4 inch outer diameter. And as the liquid, I have got 2 liters of Mayhem's Pastel UV White cooling liquid, which looks like milk, but it's a bit more see-through, so you can actually see through it. And then of course, when you hit it with UV light, it lights up like you can see on screen. To go along with all this UV stuff, I have got a CableMod CM Series VS cable kit, which is white. This replaces all of the cables for the power supply inside the computer with all these nice white cables. White, of course, reacting with UV light quite well. The SATA data cables have been replaced once again with white sleeved SATA data. Even all of the fan cables have been replaced with Phobia 3-pin fan splitter cables, which are as well white, so all of the ugly cable colors on the fans will be hidden at the back of the case. And as you can see there, that's how it will look under UV light. Also, for cable management, I've bought UV blue reactive cable ties. And of course, to make it all shine, I have bought 2 Phobia UV LED strips. This will all still be run on Windows 7 because that's where it's at. I will still be using the Blue Yeti microphone. I'll still be using the 2 HP 2159M 21.5 inch monitors, lest someone can tell me how I can get 4K monitors and film it at the right ratio so it works on YouTube. And I also have, waiting to be used, used for the mouse, the Razer Mamba Chroma, and for the keyboard, the Razer Black Widow Chroma. And because so much has also gone into aesthetics, not only will this computer kick ass, but when you look at it, you go, holy shit. And for that reason, my current Thermaltake V71 Core full tower case is going to be replaced. One, it's a bit chunky and goofy looking. The blue accents on the hard drive trays can kind of kill the vibe of the case. And also the window is filled with fractures and the rubber grommets on the inside and the cable management slots are all falling apart. So I have bought a Corsair 750D case, which I am 80% sure I can fit all of my crazy computer dreams into this case. As I said earlier, and I'm not actually sure if I did say this earlier, but I don't know that much about computers. I know what I need to know to do this, and it's all stuff I've learned off YouTube, mostly via Linus Tech Tips. So if you do know stuff about computers and any combination of these parts makes you go, uh-oh, please tell me so I can swap them out. But anyway, I think everything will go into this case, and I did have a choice of going with the Corsair 900D, but that case is massive. It is so big. It's kind of hard to tell. Like, the 750D is huge. The size of the 900D is insane. I don't know who this lovely lady is in the middle or what the case is on the right, but that case on the left is the 900D. So you get some idea of how insanely huge that case is. So because I'm confident that I can fit everything in the 750D, that's what I have gone with. So K-Buy, I hope that answers your question as to what are my entire PC setup specs. There you go, I'm sure you're all bored as hell and can't wait for me to go on holidays. In case you missed it at the start, all of the background footage has been The Elder Scrolls Online, Tamriel Unlimited. And that was just so our eyes could have a visual break from the wastelands of Fallout 4. At this point, I can't remember what I've told you to watch, but all the links will be in the description and also in the comments, most likely. Let me know your favorite characters from Elder Scrolls and Fallout. Thanks for sticking around this long. I hope all you computer nerds got excited about that stat sheet. And I will see you at some point in the next couple of days with a Fallout 4 curating curious curiosities. Also, if you haven't yet, be sure to enter Fallout 4's fantastic face-off. Again, link will be in description. It closes in like 4 days, so get on it. Thanks for watching. I'll see you soon. And to end the video, here's some random music that I stayed up very late attempting to write the other night. Here you go.